I'm sitting with the OSINT Dojo, and in this video, I have a geolocation challenge for you to solve. The purpose of these challenges are to provide you with working examples to test your OSINT skills on. They're also designed to expose you to different tools and techniques that you might want to try in other investigative scenarios later on in your career. Those familiar with our previous challenges should have a general idea of how this works. However, since we've migrated over to YouTube, let me give a bit of background first. I'm going to post a challenge to our YouTube channel with some sort of lead, perhaps some text, a photo, or a video, as well as some questions that you'll need to answer. You're then going to pause the video while you work towards your solution. Once you believe you have the answer, or if you decided to give up, you can then unpause the video and I will begin a walkthrough showing you how to solve the challenge step by step. Now then, for the first challenge, I'm simply asking you to identify the location in which I snapped this photo. You can now pause the video and come back when you're ready for the walkthrough. Now then, let's get started. Let's first assess what information we can gather from this photo in order to make our search more targeted. A few things that jump out to me is that this photo appears to be taken from a higher level above another road that runs underneath it. We also have part of what appears to be a long, but relatively short, building, and some aircraft here off to the right. If we zoom in, we can quickly see that the quality of this photo is quite poor. However, we should still have enough here to identify the airlines that own these particular planes. Our first set of planes are this bluish color, and have some gold imagery here on the tail that resembles perhaps a flower, a sun, or maybe even a sunflower. Our silver plane here in the back has something a little bit darker on its tail, but I can't quite make out what that is yet. We can also see text, and although it's difficult to make out what it says, the first letter here does appear to be a J. Let's move our photo over to the side and open up our web browser. We're going to cross-reference an image gallery of airline tail logos and see if we can identify which airline owns these planes. The great thing about this resource is that they're organized alphabetically, so let's navigate to the J's and look for a match. Let's zoom back in on our photo so we can better make a comparison. Here we have a few possible matches from Jetstar that are all on silver planes. We can also see the jet logo, as well as the red star at the bottom of the tail. If we hover over each of these examples, we can see the region name that they use, as well as what location that name operates within. Based on the length of this text, I believe that Jetstar Pacific is most likely our match. Let's look up the Jetstar Pacific airline map to obtain a list of what airports they operate in. Based on the map legend, it appears they only operate within Vietnam, which suggests that the airport in our photo is also likely in Vietnam. Let's see if we can identify the airline that owns the other plane in our photo. If we scroll down to the V section in our logo gallery, we do have an image here that suggests that our other plane is likely from Vietnam Airlines. We can see both the Gold Lotus as well as the Vietnamese flag, which matches our photo. We'll open up another tab with airline route maps and look up the flight routes for Vietnam Airlines. This company has a lot of different routes, however, based on what we saw with Jetstar Pacific, I believe that this airport is most likely in Vietnam, so let's scroll down and click on the domestic flight route. If we compare the two flight maps, we can see that Jetstar Pacific has far less cities to sort through, and at least some of these cities are present on both routes. Taking a moment to cross-check the maps, we can confirm that the three cities here at the top exist on both flight routes. These four cities, from Da Nang down to Ho Chi Minh City, are also present on both airline routes. Since Vietnam Airlines also covers all the same cities, let's focus on the Jetstar Pacific flight map to reduce our total list of cities down to 7. When searching, I tend to start off with the largest cities or those more common with tourists first. So, let's pull up Google Maps and take a look at the airport in Ho Chi Minh City. I do see that this airport also has a long building, and we do have some airplanes off behind it here on the right. But you'll notice there's no grassy area in our Google Maps view. Based on the map, I also don't see the same structure of overpass like where our photo was taken. Unfortunately, if we drop down to street view, our view of the building is blocked by these trees. However, we can see enough that tells us this is most likely not a match. We can also see the railing is different from that within our photo. Let's cross this one off for now and move on to the next. The next largest city would be Hanoi. Looking at this airport, we also have a long building here, like in our photo. Another thing we can spot is this patch of grass here in front of that building. The airplanes to the back and right of our building also show up here on our map. We can also see what appears to be ramps to an overpass, similar to the angle our photo was taken from. I feel pretty good about this one, but let's drop down to street view to confirm. The first thing I notice is we have a matching crosswalk here in both of our images. The building in the background also appears to be the same one as the one in our photo. We also have this small blue building, which I completely missed in our example image up until now. If we rotate the camera, we can see up on the overpass where this photo was taken from, complete with the matching guardrails. Finally, up here in the URL bar, we have the latitude and longitude of where this photo was captured. This is going to be the answer we're looking for to complete this challenge. If you struggled a bit to solve this challenge, I hope this walkthrough helped you understand how to pivot from each information point until you find the answer. As with most things, there's more than one way to get the correct answer here. So, if you used a different method, I highly encourage you share it in the comments below.